Hi, this is Manu.
Hi, this is Steen. So previously, we talked about the big picture with transparency and automated decision making and profiling. What are the transparency issues with each step?
Mm-hmm. Okay, so we can say that transparency is made of three big components. First of all, the information that companies have to tell you. Second, it is the timing, when they have to tell you this information. And the third component is the design or the format. Which format do they choose to tell you this information so you understand in a very clear and plain way all the information about all this equation. First, as we said previously, everything starts with data collection from us, from individuals. So as an example, how companies collect data from us? Well, we can think about our smartphones and the applications that we have in our telephones. So every time that we use our applications, even if we don't use them, they are collecting data from us. For example, our biometrical data, I'm talking about fingerprints, I'm talking about tracking, eye tracking, face recognition technology, or for example, geolocalization data. And this just as example, but there are hundreds of technologies and hundreds of thousands of data that they are collecting from us every single minute of our life. So, in the first stage, in the collecting stage, the main issue is the information that we have to have from companies and the exercising of our rights. So that's the reason why it's very important the format that the company use to let us know which are our rights. So actually we have right now a format that is not very intuitive. These are the privacy policies that you say, yes, I accept it, but we don't read it. That's the reason why we have to ask ourselves at least two questions. This is the way, or this is the best format that they can use. And second, it is the best way of explaining us which are our rights and consequences of all this equation with a super long text that nobody's going to read.
So it's a right to know what kind of data that's being collected by you, and also which rights you have, whether you can say, no thank you, I don't want you to pick up this data from me, I don't want you to process this data. And also you need to know what the purpose is. What are you going to use as a company or organization are going to use this data for? These are the three main things.
Exactly. Well, there are more rights that the data subject has, but the purpose, the reason why they are going to take your data is one of the most important things, or the most important information that a data subject, a person like you or like us, has to know. It is why a company is collecting your data to achieve their business goal. So the second stage is the databases, is how data are stored and organized. So the GDPR says, well, it has the GDPR three articles that they are the main, or they are the essence of transparency in the law. But they are articles from 13 to 15. It is the right to be notified, that is a right, or is a duty. It is a controller's duty, and the right to access to our information. We have to ask to access to our information.
Then the organization has to be really careful about how they treat your personal data. They have to at least, what's it called, pseudonymize it, so that it's not directly possible for you to go in and see that the data that's in the database. It's even better if you anonymize, so it's not possible, once you have the data, to figure out from where or from which individual this data comes. But security is always a matter of putting layer upon layer, making it as good as you can.
Yes, and I have to say that pseudonymized data, they are still personal data, because data controllers or company can still profile.
Yeah.
So there are privacy issues with pseudonymization. That's the reason why the GDPR contemplates pseudonymization in the law.
Yeah. And so once you've gotten your data anonymized, then the GDPR does not apply anymore.
Exactly, because companies, they don't know who you are. They cannot identify you.
Yeah.
It's very important to say that, as I said before, the GDPR and the Articles 13 and 14, they say that we have the right to know if there is any automated decision making, including profiling.
Yeah.
So, if you want to access to our information, we don't only want to access to the data that we have in the databases. We want to access to how these data are treated and how the algorithms are treating our information.
Yeah.
But as you said, Trade Secrets Directive, IP rights, and proprietary software, it means another kind of law, are allowing to companies to be opaque in this process. So this is an ethical decision from companies to let know
whether they want to allow you as a
or allow me as a data subject, but me as a data subject, if I want to access this information, is totally, it's not going to be useful for me because I don't understand algorithms. So
that's a whole other issue. I mean, even if the company is nice or the organization is nice and say, okay, you can know that this is a particular algorithm we're using. Well, these learning algorithms that are being used, they are so complex and they have so many parameters, typically millions of parameters, that are sort of put together in ways that the human brain can't really understand. We don't even have theories that can tell us yet how these decisions are made. So scientifically, it's not really clear what happens. Except if they were open about it, then we could have independent experts come in and actually test the algorithms, and then they could verify whether they would reach the same decision given the same input. And another thing that's important to notice is that it's not just the algorithm, it's also the training set. Depending on how these algorithms are trained, they will give different answers.
That's the reason why there's a difference between transparency and explainability.
Transparency doesn't necessarily mean that you can explain how things are working. But so out of these automated decisions are profiles.
Exactly.
So.
Well, here we are finding a real big issue with transparency. So the first question that we have to make to ourselves is that if profiling or inference data are personal data or not.
Yeah.
So depending on if they are personal data or not, I want to think, yes, we have the right to access to this information. I mean, which is the profiling, the inferences that companies have about us. But I don't want to know only which is the decision that they have made about me or a group that I belong. I want to know with whom they have shared this information, with which data they have made this decision, and which impact is going to have in my personal life, because the impact can be really serious.
We know that these profiles have been used in elections, in the Brexit, and in the last US presidential election. But they can also be, you can imagine if you have DNA, if you have DNA registers, and then, as we know, DNA to a great extent determines what your capabilities are. You might, in some dystopic future, use these profiles to deny people access to certain education.
Or they can tailor prices.
Yeah, so or that if you, yeah, that's
or
right.
Or the legal system can decide if you go to jail or not.
Yeah.
And many false positives. It means innocent people are going to jail because this profiling is not right. I would like to make the last comment about the access to our information.
Yeah.
So the GDPR or the law is protecting us from input data. It means that the data that our companies are collecting from us and they arrive until here.
Yeah,
but profiling are output data and they are not regulated. There are not any law that protect us from the profiling that companies and organizations are making from us. So when we have the right of access in the GDPR, it means that it is an ex ante right. It means that we only can have access until here, input data, the databases, how they are organized and stored. But we don't have access to the information or the inference data that the companies have about us. And there is a big issue and a big problem. And right now, we don't have any solution. The only solution is, the only solution is that companies decide as an ethical decision to give access, real access, to this information.
Yeah, so you can correct it if it is wrong, or at least contest it if you feel that it's unfair.
That's the reason why it's that important that companies give you an ex-ante explanation about what are they going to do with your data since the beginning until the end, and the impact that all this process is going to have in your life. So you can decide if you want to be involved in this process or not.